Every application adds risk. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I'm positive you know someone who can't resist installing the latest whatever, or the application or program that they've heard something about, or this offer that comes across their email. The bottom line is that they're adding lots and lots of software to the machine. I'm hoping that's not you, because it's fundamentally kind of scary. We usually talk about this scenario when things have gotten so bad that the machine is barely running because they've just installed so many different applications. But in reality, even installing a single additional application adds risk. Now, normally when we talk about risk, we assume we mean malicious risk, but in reality, it's a little bit more than that. Yes, you could accidentally download malicious software and all of a sudden you've got malware on your machine and off it goes. But there's more. For example, we regularly blindly accept terms and conditions or blindly accept the requests that some applications make of us for access to various parts of our computer or our device without really thinking whether or not they really need it. Each one of those scenarios is risk. Risk of malicious behavior, risk of privacy violation, risk of information going out into the hands of a third party that you didn't really necessarily want it to go to. This is, like I said, direct risk from the application in question. And that's something that you need to take into account whenever you choose what application to install. However, there's also what I'm going to call indirect risk. And this is actually something that I don't think people think about at all, because it applies to every single piece of software, including the operating system itself. And the indirect risk is simply this: the application, the software that you're installing, perfectly wonderful, wonderfully benign, has no issues with it whatsoever. Except, there's a bug, or two, or a design flaw, or something that nobody thought to think of, right? There's a scenario that they didn't account for. That then might allow other software, more malicious software with malicious intent, a way to make things happen that shouldn't happen. In other words, you're adding risk by adding potential vulnerabilities, even by installing otherwise benign software. Like I said, we see this with Windows itself, right? We have to run the operating system, and the operating system itself occasionally has vulnerabilities that basically put some of our stuff at risk. But the same is actually true for every other piece of software we install. They can all add vulnerabilities that in one way or another could make things worse for us. Now, I don't want to make this seem like, oh my God, we should never install anything and throw the computer out the door. That's not the way it works. The reality is, there's no such thing as perfect security. The only thing you can do is stack the deck in your favor. That means making decisions that reduce the risk. Or by not making decisions, you increase your risk. It all ultimately comes back down to trust. Trusting the vendors of the software you install, and of course, trusting yourself to install the things you need. That actually brings it back to my three recommendations when it comes to installing software. Make sure you need it. Only install the software you need. Seriously, the most secure software of all is software that's not on your device. Because then it doesn't have an opportunity to bring whatever maliciousness or vulnerabilities might be tagging along. Install only reputable software from well-known sources. By reputable, I mean, have you heard of them before? Do you know the manufacturer? Do they have a reputation for doing solid software? From sources you trust, if you can, download it from the manufacturer not third-party sites, not third-party download sites, because third-party download sites, some, not all, have been known to inject malware with the downloads. This brings us back to the three recommendations I have for you when it comes to installing software. One, don't install software you aren't certain you need. The safest software is the software that's not on your machine. So make sure that before you install something, it really is something that you expect to use and that you actually have legitimate need. If not, then why? If you're just trying to play with something, you're adding risk. Your playing adds risk. Number two, install only reputable software from trusted sources. By that I mean, have you ever even heard of the company? Do they have a reputation? Is it a good reputation? If you've not heard of them, do a little bit of research. Make sure that it is software that comes from somebody that you can at least initially trust. And finally, kind of tagging on to that last part, only download from sources you trust. By that I mean, if at all possible, download from the software vendor directly, or follow the instructions that they provide to download the software. Avoid third-party sites. Avoid download sites if at all possible. Yeah, there are some good ones out there, but there are also some nasty ones out there that will actually infect the downloads with malware. So avoid those. Always go directly to the source. And when in doubt, don't install it. You're just safer that way. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/26590. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.